Hey everybody, today is Friday, November 22nd, 2019. I'm Jalen.
And I'm Marcus.
And this is your Wolfpack News.
Kaisha Harris.
Madison Mosier.
Payne Phillip.
Jordan Campagna.
Hey Wolfpack, this is Jordan Campagna and I'm here with some national news. Bill Gates has been backing a new venture which aims to turn sunlight into a source of heat exceeding 1,000 degrees Celsius. The technology has exceeded for past that, going up to 1,500 degrees Celsius. CNN says that Bill Gates has been working on this project in stealth mode. This project that's been going on is a huge deal because of all of the potential fossil fuels being saved from it. A regular nuclear power plant contains temperatures of 300 degrees Celsius. Bill Gates' new solar discovery can go up to temperatures three times that. Bill Gates is expected to continue on this project for a very long time. We will inform you later on if there are any updates.
Hey Wolfpack, this is Payne, and today we are going to see which is better. McDonald's or Chick-fil-A?
McDonald's or Chick-fil-A? Yeah. What is your go-to?
The number one. The chicken sandwich.
And what about McDonald's?
The breakfast? Because I don't like the regular, like, you know, lunch food.
McDonald's or Chick-fil-A?
Chick-fil-A.
What's your go-to meal? What do you like better, Chick-fil-A or McDonald's?
Chick-fil-A, no question.
What's your go-to meal there?
Chicken minis. Number one, size large, no ice, sweet and sour sauce, or a Polynesian sauce, actually. What are you laughing at?
I'm laughing at you.
Why? Because I know what I like. McDonald's we call rent-a-wreck, if you know what that means. You know what that means?
No.
Rent-a-wreck?
No.
Like it goes in and then it goes out very quickly.
Okay.
That's all for today. And what do you prefer, McDonald's or Chick-fil-A?
Hey Wolfpack, here's some sports statistics for you. Did you know that basketball player LeBron James has 5 triple-doubles this season? Even after 17 years, LeBron James still finding new records to set for his career. He became the first player in the league history to record a triple-double against all 30 teams. He finished the game against Oklahoma City with 25 points, 11 rebounds, and 10 assists. It was James' 5th triple-double of the season, which included a 3-game streak of triple-doubles to begin this month. On November 5th, James told reporters, "A triple-double means absolutely nothing to him if it's not the win." It seems like he's been playing forever, and his impact hasn't lessened over time. Maybe he and Tom Brady are having some kind of competition. Who's the greater GOAT in their respective sports, Wolfpack? James or Brady? Hey Wolfpack, here's a story about an area close to us that seems to be having some dangerous activity. A female runner was attacked during her Thursday morning jog. The woman was running along York Avenue between Gobron and Sudbury streets near Ollie's Pond around 6:45 a.m. According to the Charlotte County Sheriff's Office press release, an unknown person attacked her. The victim, who is suffering from minor injuries, was able to get away from the person. The unknown male was wearing a gray hoodie and pants with a knit ski mask. Deputies believe this is not an isolated incident. A similar attack took place 2 weeks ago at dusk to a separate victim. To help add a sense of security and improve the effort to find the unknown man, CCSO plans to increase patrols to the area. The sheriff's office reportedly can't offer a sketch of the unknown assailant because he was reported to wear a ski mask. Try to stay away from this area, and if you see anything suspicious, report it to the authorities immediately. Stay safe, Wolfpack.
Information guaranteed to blow your mind.
I am the smartest man alive!
Hey Wolfpack, here's today's big brain challenge. What is the biggest tree in the world? A, the elm tree. B, the banyan tree. C, the sequoia tree. D, the maple tree. The answer is C, the sequoia. The largest tree in the world is a giant sequoia in California's National Sequoia Park. Called General Sherman, the tree is about 52,500 cubic feet.
Hey Wolfpack, there's an iguana apocalypse in Florida, or at least that's what it looks like judging from the photos word Floridians are posting all over social media. Because of Emily Maple, the reptile keeper at the Palm Beach County Zoo, said the cold-blooded animals get cold stunned. That is, they basically freeze if the temperature gets below 45 degrees Fahrenheit. Maple went on to say, if it's just for a day or two, they'll just get to where they're completely frozen in time. They're still able to breathe. They're still able to do bodily functions, just very slow. So watch out for those falling temperatures, Wolfpack. It might lead to falling iguanas, too.
Those were good days.
Hey Wolfpack, here's a joke of the day. Why did the picture go to jail? Because it got framed. That's it for today's broadcast. And remember, if it's news, it's at the Academy. Friday, November 22nd, 2019.
I'm Marcus. I thought you said I was gonna go first.
Restart. November 22nd, 2019. I'm Jalen.
No, Marcus.
And this is your Wolfpack News.
Why everybody staring at me? I don't like it.